The names Norse, Welty, and James are in the Broadcast Hall of Fame.
They were KSL's legendary news team during what we finally refer to as the golden years of TV news. News specialist Carol Makita had an opportunity to sit down one-on-one with the man who led that team, Dick Norse.
Dick Norse, the face.
Good evening. I'm Dick Norse.
And the voice of KSL 5 News for more than 40 years. Reminders of that distinguished career hang in the office of his St. George home.
I think that captured probably what I really felt every night when there were 10 seconds to air. I probably had that look on my face.
Mm-hmm. I think you did.
Treatments for throat cancer have affected that resonant voice some, but not his sense of pride and responsibility for the role he carried for decades.
The thing that's disturbed me the most is today's fake news claims. I really get upset when I hear that. Journalism is a fine profession, and one we will always need regardless of technology. Somebody has to find the answers for you and tell you, and that's what we do.
So I wondered, does he miss it?
I really miss what I did. The biggest part, I think, were the people I worked with.
And the two he misses most are Bob Welty, meteorologist, and Paul James, sportscaster. They became the iconic team inducted into the Broadcast Hall of Fame. Both passed away this year.
They were super. Those two guys were, they became like brothers to me, Carol. They really did.
One of the things I remember most about you is how exacting you were every day with every script. Why was that?
That's a little of my OCD coming out, but I did not want to stumble around in anything. That was the reasoning behind all that. I just wanted to get it right.
Over the years, Dick's deep baritone was there, covering everything from Ted Bundy's execution.
Ted Bundy is labeled by law enforcers as one of the most vicious killers ever.
To the Mark Hoffman bombings, to the 2002 Winter Olympics in Salt Lake. But his most memorable assignment was a trip to cover our Utah servicemen in Vietnam in 1967.
This is Marine Lance Corporal Michael Totten from Murray, Utah.
From bases to battleships, he brought their stories home.
So many had the one response when they left: will you call my mother and tell her I'm all right? Then I proceeded to call all the mothers and say, hey, Tom's let me call you and say hi.
His career nearly ended in 1980 with the first of three devastating cancer diagnoses.
It spread from my neck to my chest to my abdomen, so three stages.
But he came back.
We cried together and welcome back, Dick. And, you know, it's not the same without you.
The love people throughout Utah gave him, Dick says, taught him a valuable lesson.
And so I started doing a lot of charity work, and I loved that as much, sometimes more than my job.
What is it that you hope people will remember the most about you?
Probably that oath of office I took to uphold all the principles of journalism. I would like to be remembered as somebody who really cared about that oath that I didn't take, but it seemed like I took.
That silent oath that he made to himself is what he shares with young journalists. Nothing bothers him more than how some in America think of journalism today.
We are not the enemy of the people, have never been. And, you know, you take it very seriously in this country because you have freedom of the press. And the majority of us do it quite responsibly. The major networks are not fake news. I have faith in them all the way. The local stations, I have as much faith in as I ever did.
Dick Norse, still passionate about his career and about today's news, and he said he always will be. Carol Makita, KSL 5 News, St. George.
Oh, it's fun to see him. You know, we miss he'd come in here every night and in his big voice say, hey, you guys.